Begging the question is a very important fallacy. In my mind, it might be the most important fallacy to understand on this whole list, because it bears directly on what it means to offer someone reasons for believing something. I'm going to split this topic into two discussions. The first one will focus on begging the question in what I call its narrow sense, which is basically synonymous with circularity or circular reasoning. And the second one will focus on what I call the broader sense of begging the question, which is maybe less familiar, but arguably even more important. Let me first make a note about another way in which the term to beg the question is often used in ordinary language. Here is a recent headline from a car blog. Honda recalls 1.3 Yaris models, which begs the question, what's the plural of Yaris? And here's a Seth Meyers joke from Weekend Update on Saturday Night Live. A walrus at a zoo in Turkey has become a major attraction after learning to play the saxophone, which begs the question, how bored are Turkish zookeepers that they're just strapping instruments to animals and seeing what takes? So in this context, to beg the question means something like to raise the question or to inspire the question. People use this expression all the time. There's nothing wrong with it. But what I want to emphasize here is that this is not the sense that's intended when we talk about begging the question as a fallacy of argumentation. Just like the terms valid and invalid, there's a common usage in ordinary language, and there's a more formal logical usage, which we want to keep separate. But unlike the logical sense of the term valid, the logical sense of to beg the question is fairly widely known and used outside of logic. So both this more colloquial sense and the logical sense that we'll look at next are in play in ordinary language. But some people use the term almost exclusively in the sense of to raise or inspire a question, and aren't even aware of the logical sense. So my advice is to be on the lookout for confusions that might arise from misunderstanding the sense in which you're using this term. In logic, we say that an argument begs the question when, in some way or another, it assumes as true precisely what is at issue in the argument. Another way to put this is that the argument contains a premise that in some way asserts or presumes to be true what is being asserted in the conclusion. Another common way of saying the same thing is that the reasoning in the argument is circular. Here's the basic logical form of an argument that begs the question in this sense. You've got an argument with premises P1, P2, and so on, down to Pn. And one of them means the same thing as the conclusion C, or assert something that is logically equivalent to C. If this happens, then we'd say that this premise begs the question, meaning that it assumes as true precisely what is at issue, namely, whether the conclusion C is true or not. We call this circular because the conclusion C is supposed to be drawing logical support from this premise, but the premise is simply restating the conclusion. So the argument as a whole involves nothing more than repeating the conclusion without giving any additional reasons to believe it. Here's an example. Capital punishment is justified for cases of murder because the state has a right to put someone to death for having killed someone else. Maybe this doesn't sound too bad when said this way, but let's put this argument in standard form. Notice that this is just a one-liner. And notice that, even though the wording is different, the single premise and the conclusion are asserting the same thing. After all, the state has a right to put someone to death just means capital punishment is justified. And for having intentionally killed someone else just means for cases of murder. So saying this is just like saying capital punishment is justified for cases of murder, therefore capital punishment is justified for cases of murder. But obviously this won't do as an argument. The issue is whether capital punishment is justified for cases of murder. That's the question that's being begged by this argument. Here's some other examples. Skydiving is dangerous because it's unsafe. Paper is combustible because it burns. These are just different ways of saying the same thing. Of course, if skydiving is unsafe, then it's dangerous, because that's just what unsafe means. And combustible just means can burn. So the first begs the question, why is skydiving unsafe? And the second begs the question, why does paper burn? But these are pretty obvious examples. Here's a sneakier one. Murder is morally wrong. This being the case, then abortion must also be morally wrong. Here we're not given a mere restatement of a premise, so the fallacy is a bit harder to detect. But when you put the argument in standard form and fill in the background premise that the argument relies on, then you get this. This argument relies on the assumed premise that abortion is murder. If we grant this premise, then the conclusion follows immediately, since calling abortion murder implies that it's morally wrong. But this begs the question that is at issue, namely, whether abortion should be classified as murder. This argument gives us no additional reason to accept the conclusion. It would never persuade anyone who didn't already believe that abortion was wrong. This is a good example of a very common way that circular arguments can pass themselves off as genuine arguments. You give an argument that leaves out a key premise necessary to draw the conclusion, and let your audience fill it in. This key premise assumes precisely what is really at issue in the argument. It's the offending circular premise. But because it goes unstated, it's less likely to be called out and brought under critical scrutiny. And this helps to make the argument seem superficially persuasive. So, to sum up, when we use the term begging the question in logic, we mean that an argument is guilty of assuming as true something that really needs to be argued for, if the argument can qualify as offering reasons to accept the conclusion. Arguments that beg the question don't offer any reasons to anyone who didn't already accept the conclusion. When I say that an argument begs the question in the narrow sense, I'm referring specifically to arguments that employ premises that are roughly equivalent in meaning to what the conclusion is asserting. In the next tutorial, I'll loosen this definition and examine how a broader class of arguments might be described as begging the question.